GFP recovery begins with the arrival of the broth tank. A sterile hose is run from the broth tank to the Disk-Stack Centrifuge, and the tank is pressurized to drive the broth into the centrifuge. Once the centrifuge reaches a stable running speed, the inlet valve is opened and broth enters the bowl. The centrifugal force causes the solids to collect on the sides of the bowl, much like the spin cycle on your clothes washer. The liquid flows through and out of the centrifuge. As more broth enters the bowl, it displaces the clarified liquid to the top of the bowl where it exits, while the cells continue to build up on the bowl surface. The liquid leaving the bowl is known as the clarified stream because almost all the solids have been removed. The solids are the E. coli cells, and they contain the product. A sensor monitors the clarified stream for percent solids. When the bowl has reached capacity for solids, the bowl opens and the solids are discharged into an appropriate container for collection. Once the solids are discharged, the centrifugation step can resume, while the clarified liquid is waste. At this point, the cells are in a paste form, and although most of the liquid has been removed, our cell paste is still about 40% liquid by weight. The remaining liquid contains high levels of metabolites and salts that could complicate downstream processing, so we're going to lower those levels by washing the cells. The cell paste is suspended in a buffered solution and then run through the centrifuge again. As the clarified liquid leaves the centrifuge this time, it carries many of the contaminants from the fermentation step with it.